Luke chapter 24, verse 5. Then as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but risen." I repeat it. Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Happy Resurrection Day. This is Pastor Apto from Fairfax, Virginia. I greet you in the name of our Lord Jesus. As you see the smile on my face, this is a very special season of the year. We celebrate the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. Jesus is alive. 2,000 years ago, God, the second person, the Son of the living God, came in the flesh, died for the sin of mankind, and rose from the dead 3 days later. And Jesus is alive. That's why we are so bold when we preach Jesus. He is alive. Jesus saves. Jesus heals. Jesus sets free. He is real. So today, I just wanted to say a few things about this Lord we worship. We have to remember, as we celebrate this Resurrection Day, we have to remember what God has done for us through His Son, Jesus. Jesus bore our sin. By taking on Himself our sin, He has reconciled us back to God. He opened the door of heaven to every one of us. So we have to be grateful. We have to thank Him. We have to say thank you, Jesus, from the bottom of our hearts for what He has done. He is a wonderful Lord and He loves you. As I greet and as I speak about the resurrection of our Lord Jesus, if there is anyone who has never made this Jesus a savior of your life, this is your day. This is your season. He loves you. He gave His life to you. If it was only you in this world, He would have come and died for you alone. Brothers and sisters, wherever you are at, if you open up your heart and accept Jesus as your personal Savior, instantly your name will be written in the book of life. When you leave this earth, you are going to heaven and live on with God forever and ever. There are a lot of things today people are scared of. As we know, the whole world is at great tension this time. This virus is all over the world, out of control. But the scariest thing in life, something terrible that could happen to someone, is leaving this earth without Jesus. The Word of God says, if you confess Jesus as your Lord, and also believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you shall be saved. Romans chapter 10, verse 9. If you make that confession, instantly your name will be written in the book of life. You know, things are out of control of the leaders of nations of the world, out of control of medical science. But there is one medicine. That is Jesus. Jesus is a cure for sin, a cure for coronavirus, a cure for any kind of disease. Because the Word of God says, God has exalted His Son Jesus and gave Him the name above every other name. The name Jesus. God has exalted. So, any virus, coronavirus is a name. The name of Jesus is above that. So, I just want to bring to your attention that you give your life to Him. Giving our life to Jesus means we have to confess Him as our personal Savior. You know, salvation comes only through Christ Jesus. We cannot receive salvation but just by joining churches. It's good to join church. You can be a church member. Until you confess Jesus as your personal Savior, you cannot be saved. Oh, we cannot receive salvation by doing things for, even by helping mission works or by feeding poor or this and that. All these things are good. It's good to do good. But we cannot receive salvation. Salvation comes only through Christ Jesus. You know, sin is a nature within the sinner. Our first parents, Adam and Eve, they disobeyed God. Since Adam is the head of all mankind, when he sinned, we were all in him. So we are all sinners until we meet Jesus. That's the reason why Jesus became human and died on the cross and took on himself and paid everything heaven demands to reconcile mankind back to God. To God be the glory. So I encourage every one of you, I'm not trying to say join this this religion organization or that. I am preaching to you Jesus. Jesus is the Savior, not different religion organizations. That's why we preach Jesus boldly. There is no other way to heaven except Jesus. The reason we say that, we're not trying to say that our faith is better than others or trying to make ours. It's not about that. But we are preaching this because Jesus is the only way. He is the truth. He saves. There are thousands of religions in the world today. You find Savior in Christian faith. So I encourage you, as we celebrate Jesus, his resurrection, let us invite this Jesus to our lives and make him our personal Savior. Hallelujah. 1 John 5:12 says, he who has the Son has life. He who doesn't have the Son of God does not have life. So I encourage you, as you get together and have lunch, our dinner together, I encourage you to bring this Jesus into your life. Hallelujah. So I am here to say Happy Resurrection Day. In the meantime, I want to invite you to give your life to Jesus. You know, accepting Jesus as our personal Savior, it doesn't have a whole lot of things to do. Just a prayer of 1 minute determines where you spend eternity. Where you spend eternity in your life is determined by just a prayer of 1 minute. So I'm going to lead you in prayer at the end of this message. You can follow me and repeat after me what I say. And if you do that, your name will be written in the book of life and you will become a new creature. Hallelujah. Let's bow our heads. If there is anyone who is listening to me who has never made Jesus his personal Savior, please repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I come to you. Forgive my sins. Wash me with your blood. Write my name in the book of life. From today on, I accept Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. Lord Jesus, you are the Lord of my life. I believe in my heart that you're Lord and confess with my mouth that God has raised you from the dead. In Jesus' name, amen. Folks, if you prayed this prayer and I believe you became born again, I encourage you to look for the right church, the church that teaches the word of God, the church that believes in the work of the Holy Spirit, so that you can grow in the Lord and also pass on to others this good news. Hallelujah. And I have also a message for born-again believers who accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, children of God who are worshiping God in truth and in the Spirit right now. I have a message for you too. You know, these days, from what I see, not only one place, I'm not condemning any person, the church has neglected about telling the saving power of the gospel to others. We have to spread the gospel. God will not come down and reach people. He reached them through us. Let us pass on to others the love we received through the death and resurrection of Jesus. Those friends at work, neighbors, those people whom you say they're big shot, if they don't have Jesus in their life, when they leave this earth, they're going to be separated from God throughout eternity. That's a terrible punishment. Let's just go out and tell, especially these days, the whole world is confused. There is one way out. We have that way. We have that way in our lives. We have tested Him, and that way is Jesus. Tell others, please. I don't even see people telling about Jesus to others. I don't see people on the street talking about Jesus anymore. That's not a good sign. We have to tell others. We have to pass on to others the life we received from God. Jesus is the only way. The Word of God says in 2 Corinthians 4:4, the God of this world, which is the devil, small g, has blinded the eyes of those people who do not believe. They are blind. They don't know where to turn, what to do. Someone has to pray for them and go and tell them. Prayer is good to pray for the salvation of mankind, but we have to go out and tell them, because when we tell them, faith comes by hearing the Word of God. It's that Word of God creates faith in them and accept Jesus. So let us just lift up this holy name and announce to the whole world there is a Savior. His name is Jesus. Jesus, who came 2,000 years ago to this earth, died on the cross for our sin, rose from the dead 3 days later. Jesus saves. May the Lord bless you. Let's bow our heads and pray for you and for everyone who is watching this. Dear Heavenly Father, I just want to say thank you. There is no distance in the Spirit, Father God. I bless my brothers and sisters wherever they are at as they celebrate this amazing and special season of the year, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. Father God, I pray for believers who know you in person, that they may open up their mouth, Father God, and speak about Jesus, the saving power of the gospel of Jesus. Father God, let the love of God stir up in their hearts right now. And I pray for all churches around the world, Father God. The number one agenda that brought Jesus to this earth is the salvation of mankind. Father, help us. Help every one of us to testify about Jesus. And we thank you. We give glory and honor. Also, I just want to thank you for those who confessed you as your personal, as their personal Savior right now, who got saved. Father God, teach them and lead them to the right church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, and God bless you.